You are watching Kit Cabinet, and this is the inbox review of the Zvezda T3485 in 1/72 scale.
Now, I'm not normally into tanks because, well, tanks don't fly and... Oh. But this little snap kit got my attention. So let's have a look inside. Now here's the main sprue. And let's have a closer look. Yeah, the detail looks very nice and very crisp. And especially these wheels look very nice and very detailed. This kit reminds me a bit of the Yak 3, which is also a snap fit kit, but it's also a very nicely detailed model. Now, supposedly the turret detail isn't entirely correct, but I have a trick for that. Not what you might think though. But what you do notice is that the detail, the whole surface, is a bit, yeah, basic. There's like no real surface structure. A lot of these T-34s, they looked like they had been slapped together from a bunch of rolled steel plates. And this one looks quite clean. There is some weld detail here. It's very, very subtle. Maybe that's all you would see at this scale, but... And also, when you look at the box art, you see a lot of these handles here and extra detail, but it's not included on the kit. So, if you want to make these handles, you'd have to make them yourself. Maybe from copper wire or something. The model does require some cleanup though, here. The ejector pin marks. And here's the hull. Looking good. And the tracks. Now, the tracks are made of styrene. So they're not these rubbery, boingy things that will go everywhere. You have to take care to fold these into the right position though. They're nice and thin, so they're flexible enough. And also, if you want to paint styrene, it's of course hell of a lot easier than this traditional rubbery tracks. You've got this one tiny decal sheet for the version that's on the box. Looking nice. The instructions. Now, this is a snap kit, so you would say easy assembly. Maybe that's partially true. You might want to secure some parts with glue. Anyways, with the wheels and the tracks, you can put parts on and remove them again, because it's a snap kit, to paint them and then reassemble everything, which can be very handy while constructing tanks, because the wheels are sometimes a bit tricky to get nicely painted when everything is already fixed on your kit. Your finishing stage, there are a couple of basic stores, like, well, the drums are always there, a couple of spare tracks, a cable, but nothing fancy. And of course the handles, if you want them there, get out some copper wire. And this is what the assembled model would look like. It's not a bad little thing. So I think that for a snap kit, this is a very nice model. It's not like a top detailed model, but maybe just nice enough for what I intend to do with it, which is, we'll have to wait and see.